been training MMA full time since. He wants a knockout tonight, Sean.
Absolutely. Beautiful story.
One other notable fact about Josh Poliquin, he worked at a Pizza Hut.
How about that?
Just to show you how far he's come. He'll leave these jobs, he'll leave a security company because he wanted to focus on fitness and fitness alone. Drops 70 pounds, and for anybody who has an inkling of how hard that is, it is extremely difficult to be that disciplined, to have that much grit, and to want to be. He doesn't want to just win tonight. He wants to be the heavyweight champion of the entire freaking world.
He wants a pizza after he wins, that's for sure.
Chris Putten weighed in at 249.7 pounds. He's going to have a slight weight advantage. And you can see the crowd really not for Chris tonight.
I don't know if they're not for Chris or if they're just that much for Juggernaut.
That means they're not for Chris.
Yes. We're not hearing the same kind of reaction for this gentleman.
Not to say he's a bad guy. He's a great man. We got a chance to talk to him yesterday with his wife and his son by his side as well. He's looking to make a name for himself as well. Amateur fighter.
What gym is Chris from?
Chris Putten hails from Queen Creek, Arizona, but he's independent, not affiliated with a gym.
Oh, okay.
As far as I'm aware, that's what my notes have.
He's out in my neck of the woods. See if I can get him over to my gym.
Chris Putten, born in 1991. Josh the Juggernaut Poliquin, born in 1992. Last fight was a 15-year age difference. This one, just a single year.
Wow.
And the interesting thing about this fight is that both of these guys are looking to get back into the fight game. Both of these guys trained very, very hard to get to this point so that they can make a name for themselves. They're on the same playing field for the most part. Heavyweight division and a schedule for 3 3-minute rounds. Your third man in the cage once again, Ryan Bruderman.
In the blue corner, making his amateur debut. Official weight of 245.2 pounds.
Griffin Thomas.
Fighting out of Spartan Nation in Mesa, Arizona.
It's tough to do during the fight, though. It's tough to do during the fight.
You get it today.
What do y'all want to do? If we have another
Paul McQuinn.
If not, I just
want to
keep it
going.
Yeah.
We got a good vibe, though.
His opponent fighting out of the red corner, also making his amateur debut. With an official weight of 249.7 pounds, he's an independent fighter out of Queen Creek, Arizona.
There we go.
Presenting Chris Putten.
Okay. I didn't know how to pronounce his last name. That was Putten.
Chris Putten. Third man in the octagon is Ryan Brueggemann. The Juggernaut seeks to finish Putten. Chris wants that win just as bad.
These are big guys.
Poliquin stalking his prey.
Oh! One hit. One
that is
hit.
It
is
Ryan
over.
Ryan Brueggemann calls it off. What a one-punch walk-off KO by Chris Putten.
Let him stay down. Let him stay down.
Hope you guys didn't blink at home. You may have just missed that one.
Wow.
Wow.
You can see the Juggernaut is...
First hit, guys.
He
first
is protesting
hit.
This stoppage.
Maybe that one was a little early, guys. The other one before, I'm okay with. They might have let that one play out a little bit. He could have took his back. He was in a downed position.
I mean, that was seconds. I'm not sure what the official call was. The crowd is silent. Once again, this was a heavy Josh Poliquin crowd, and Chris Putten comes in here and shuts everybody up.
Yep.
Amateur heavyweight action does not get more cataclysmic than that from Chris Putten.
Chris Putten with not a hair moved on his head. That's how quick this fight was. And yeah, you got to feel for the Poliquin fan base here. People really, really got behind him tonight, us included. We were very excited to see him as well. Very, very unfortunate for him.
You know,
he'll bounce back.
We talk about defensive holes. Josh Poliquin walked forward with his chin up in the air. Chris Putten read that like a book and delivered a massive cross to put the lights out.
Yeah,
I mean, the lights weren't out, but
look.
You know, Ryan Brueggemann saw enough.
Yeah. No, safety of the fighters is first, guys. We gotta say it. We can't say it enough. Safety of the fighters is first. He saw the hole. He went for it. It was great. First punch,
and
guys.
I will say, that's the first time that a fighter from the red corner has won tonight. It's all been blue corner up until Chris Putton to finally turn the tables for that red corner.
Getting some momentum here in the red side.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has called this fight 8 seconds into the first round for your winner by stoppage out of the red corner. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Putton.
Tell us, as an independent fighter, how did your preparation go through in this time? You know, how did you prepare? What did you do to get ready for tonight?
Garage gym, CrossFit Inside, shout out, Mesa, Arizona, CrossFit Inside, check it out.
Any big thank yous and shout outs for tonight?
Thank you, one and only up top. Thank you to my kids, family watching at home. Thank you to my wife.
Congratulations.
Good job. One more time for Chris Putton.
Donnell Loss, Shane Soley, 61. Donnell Loss, guys.
Now before I bring in your next
fighter, choked out.
I'd like you guys to, if you can, leave a nice review for Club Stratus. These guys allow us to put on this program. We're here at least once or twice a month, and these guys are awesome. Those bartenders always work hard for us. We want to make sure we leave them positive reviews so everybody knows this is the best show in town. So please, guys, do that for me and help me welcome.
How's that one punch, guys? Give us some comments here on the message board.
Here comes Seth the Man Stucker, 23 years young. He's a lifelong martial artist. Began at age 12 when his father, Rob Stucker, said, hey, this is what your life's going to look like. But he's loved it the entire way. Ahead of this fight camp, he said he's worked on his cardio, gas tank improvement, and being able to tread in these deep waters. We just saw an 8-second KO, but Seth Stucker wants to make this one a little bit longer than that.
Yes,
I will say the one caveat is he's had 5 weight cuts in the last 3 months. That's a lot of weight cutting to do in such a short period of time, Sean.
We touched on that earlier about the weight cutting. And there's negative returns if you cut too much too quick. You have to be able to do it right. You got to have the right people, the right coach, everybody talking to you through a weight cut like that. It's super important.
Seth Stucker has cited Demetrius Johnson and the Swiss Karataka, Andy Hug, as two of his favorite fighters. That's what we can be looking forward to. Some serious kickboxing credentials.
Figuratively, big shoes.
And such a unique duo whenever you have a father and son team. Rob Stucker obviously watched his son grow up, go through this competition, and now at the age of 23, Seth Stucker is here in Rage in a Cage to make the debut.
I'll remind you of somebody's comment earlier when I was talking about my father. Daddy itches. A different thing when your father pushes you into it when you're young. You just develop differently. You have different goals.
All right, fight fans, help me welcome Benny Say to the red corner.
Born in 2004, 18 years young, here comes Benny Stein. Grew up boxing and around 15 years old began training in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and wrestling. While he says that no fighter really resembles his style, he loves Anderson the Spider Silva and Israel the Last Stylebender Adesanya. Jack, we got to talk to him. What do you make of Benny
Stein? He mentioned a lot of big names. He mentioned Anderson Silva. He mentioned a guy named Conor McGregor, if you know who that is. Israel Adesanya,
Johnson,
Brock Lesnar, like all these guys, he said they're all unique in their own way, but nobody is as unique as I am, and you're going to see that tomorrow night.
I'm anxious to see his hands. I've been waiting for this kid. I want to see how well he does. He comes from a good boxing program down there. can't wait to see it.
Let's see if history repeats itself. The second and last 18-year-old on this card. Action, Ashton Jackson couldn't get it done. Maybe Benny Sines can. We're going to send it inside the octagon to Ryan the Herald Holloman.
Ladies and gentlemen, your seventh bout of the evening takes place in the lightweight division and is scheduled for three 3-minute